Assalamu alaikum everyone. Hope so guys you are fit and fine. Alhamdulillah, we are doing cool and dandy by the grace of Almighty Allah. In this video, I will just share with you FMBBC Radio, because I don't believe if anybody, anyone try to improve his or her listening skills or other skills, so obviously you or they have to listen BBC FM radio. That's why every day Ask Your English with Mr. Ibra uploaded BBC FM radio. Hope so guys you will get huge benefit or unlimited benefit from this channel and to hear a lot of BBC FM radio. So let's enjoy together and try to improve our listening skills. So
1968, the version with Jane Birkin became a mini scandal. The BBC banned it for being too sexy. In Paris, the new exhibition at the National Library reminds us this was the original version opposite Brigitte Bardot. Gainsbourg was admired for reinventing Gallic cool for the rock era. The exhibition's co-curator is Anatole Magyar.
The basis of the exhibition is the 550 song titles that are written on the facades of the exhibition. They're all there from, you know, 1954 until 1990. A lot of them are in our collective culture as French people, but also internationally with songs like Je t'aime non plus, Bonnie and Clyde, Aux armes, etc. These are songs that have had a major, major impact here in France. Alors voilà, Clyde a une petite amie.
In 1968, the song Bonnie and Clyde was a product of Gainsbourg's brief relationship with Brigitte Bardot. Caroline Reynaud of the library says no one in the 1950s would have predicted Serge Gainsbourg would turn out an admired musician and writer.
He had this very particular way to sing at the audience, and at first it was a disaster.
He kind of probably always knew that he had some kind of a destiny to fulfill. It's one of the, how do you say, the contradictions of this personality, you know, very shy and at the same time wanting to express something.
Oddly, what the utterly French Gainsbourg sometimes expressed himself in was the English language.
Serge Gainsbourg was one of the first to work really the French language and to make it sound proper with rock. French has a problem with the way it sounds. He was one of the first to bring inside French language some English words. And there was this song called Comic Strip, we all know in France, with all this shbam, pop, blop. For the meaning, like the poets. This song, Comment te diras-tu, meaning how to say goodbye, it's rhymes in X, and we don't have many words in X in France. So he had to cut the words. Sous aucun prétexte, je ne veux avoir de réflexe malheureux. Il faut que tu m'expliques un peu mieux comment te diras-tu.
The new exhibition centers on Serge Gainsbourg as writer, but he was one of the most popular French celebrities of his generation.
His shyness was one of the elements that drove him to, you know, this very provocative character that, you know, we see appear from the 80s. As with, you know, any good double, especially literary ones, at the end, the act finishes by taking over the initial personality.
Serge Gainsbourg is remembered now for some very ill-tempered TV appearances, and when he was young, for attracting some very beautiful women. The exhibition at the Pompidou Centre wants us to remember as well a prolific and inventive writer.
On Serge Gainsbourg. And finally, a Bolivian man has recounted his experience of being missing in the Amazon for a month, one of the longest known periods someone has survived in the rainforest alone. Jonathan Acosta was reported missing by friends he'd become separated from during a hunting trip in late January, before being found by rescue teams last Saturday. The newsroom's Andrew Ochieng reports.
Chants of "You are a black champion" as Jonathan Acosta made his way home. Videos published online by Bolivian media shows him being assisted to walk by what looks like medical personnel, his face swollen. Mr. Acosta spoke about his ordeal after being admitted to hospital.
It's unbelievable. I couldn't believe that people were still looking for me after all this time.
The 30-year-old told journalists he'd walked 40 kilometers to find civilization, but realized he was going round in circles. It rained half the time he was lost, he said. He used his rubber boots to collect whatever rainwater he could, but when the skies dried up, he had to drink his own urine.
I ate worms, insects. You have no idea what I had to go through all these days. I thank God very much because he gave me a new life.
While 30 days is one of the longest times a human is known to have survived alone in the Amazon, in 2021 a Brazilian pilot survived 38 days in the jungle after crash landing.
Andrew Ocheng. Now, our main news this hour, that train crash in Greece. Developing story, as we just heard, the station master of the city of Larissa has been charged with manslaughter by negligence. He was in charge of signalling. He denies any wrongdoing. Stay tuned for more on that story. That was the newsroom.
Hello, and thanks for joining us here on the BBC World Service, where in half an hour you can hear 60 minutes of news and comment in News Hour with Razia Rigvar.
A winner has been announced in the Nigerian presidential election, but opposition parties say the vote was rigged. Dozens of people are dead in a head-on train crash in Greece, and a new retrospective of the French musician Serge Gainsbourg.
Then Stephen Sagar's guest on Hard Talk is Tikhon Diatko, editor-in-chief of one of Russia's last independent news channels.
We received six million new viewers who never watched TV rain before.
And at BBCWorldService.com, the invention of Russia explores how the country's beginnings shape the country we see today.
Moscow has had contacts with the West since the end of the 15th century, but they've been fairly sporadic.
You can hear more at BBCWorldService.com.
I'm Gareth Mitchell with Digital Planet this half hour here on the BBC World Service. From Ukraine, the app that allows citizens to report the likes of drones and missiles and help authorities defend the country's airspace.